Good morning, NBHS. My name is Joe Carbone.
And I'm Jerry Camp. Welcome to this edition of T-Bird News.
Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Bree Diutai tagged along with the environmental classes and got her hands and feet dirty at the field trip at Chatfield Hollow. Let's go see what she got herself into.
Every year, the AP Environmental and AP Bio kids go to Chatfield Hollow. This year had to get pushed back because of the triple E, but let's go see how it went.
So span out, find your trees.
One of the first things that the AP Environmental students did was check out the ages of the trees and determine what kind they were. Let's go see what Andrew Toledo learned about the different trees.
You know, so essentially there's some trees over there because that's a forest. And essentially in the forest, there's trees that are like standing and dead, and then trees that are falling over and dead, and then trees that are rotted, and then trees that are really rotted. So we essentially looked at all those different stages and, you know, we took a look at the organisms present and stuff, and it was a pretty cool thing. So yeah.
Now that we got the point of view from the AP Environmental students, let's go see what the AP Bio class did.
Basically, in AP Bio, we had different quadrants where we figured out the types of trees and the amount of trees in that quadrant. And me and my partner, Alyssa, figured out that we had one white oak, one American elm, and a bunch of beeches.
I spoke with this Redmond to see what this trip was all about.
We are here with AP Biology and AP Environmental classes to test the water quality here at Chatfield Hollow of the pond and the stream, as well as looking at the macroinvertebrates, which are the bugs, and they are a good indicator of the quality of the water.
Although the students weren't able to go out to the pond, they were still able to complete all these tests. Even though there were some minor inconveniences throughout the trip, the students still had a good time. For T-Bird News, I'm Bree Diutai.
Speaking of field trips, our very own Jay Guerrero traveled with the world language students to an important location. Let's see where the students went and how the trip is.
Spanish class went to the most well-known places throughout the country. Let's go see where they went and how it went.
We're about to go on a tour of New York City.
Students of the Spanish class were given the opportunity to visit New York and its important locations. Let's hear our school Spanish teachers give a brief explanation about the trip and how the trip was.
First time that we come here, but every year we do plan a trip to New York. And in the past, we've gone to Ellis Island, the Statue of Liberty. And this year, it was Mr. Yerkes' turn to plan. So he actually came up with this entire idea.
We decided we wanted to see some of the immigrant areas. We went to Little Italy, Chinatown.
The tour was
a walking
really cool
tour, as well as a bus tour a little bit. We ate Little Italy, had some pizza.
Right.
Then went over to the UN, 20, very educational. End of the day here in El Mercado.
So the Spanish Mercado, which you can, it's just like a street in Spain, where you can go from place to place and get different types of food. I know I had the tortilla de patatas and the churros, they were excelentes.
Well, it's a full day when you start your day off with dumplings in Chinatown, then get a pizza in Little Italy.
I had a tortilla and a little bit of vegetables as well, so we were able to show them a little bit of Italy and Spain and close to them.
I know, and did we have fun, everybody?
Yeah!
Alright, see you in North Brantford. Foot on the gas, head on the floor, hopping out before the vehicle crash. I'm on the road yelling 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I am the greatest rapper alive. So damn great, I go for them, I've died. What you hearing now is a paranormal vibe. House on the hill, house on the beat.
Students were lucky enough to see the extraordinary places that surround their city that represented how diverse the city is. Here's one of the AP students now.
I love La Reina, Senora Tetzo, and she makes the class really fun.
The students and staff had a vast amount of fun this trip. Let's see the next trip when they go to Spain next year. For TBN News, I'm Jason Guerrero.
Citizenship, integrity, responsibility, consideration, leadership, and empathy. Those are our circle expectations. And the day before Thanksgiving, we had our annual Full Circle Awards Assembly. Jerry Camp has us with a scoop.
I'm Jerry Camp, and I'm here to bring you the news on the Full Circle Awards.
On Wednesday, November 27th, we had the Full Circle Assembly to show our appreciation for the students who follow circle expectations.
Hello, everyone. Today, there will be two awards handed out. Each award honors students who have demonstrated exceptional character here at NPHS.
There were winners in every grade, and this year was record-breaking with over 510 student nominations. I was able to talk to Marlena to see how she felt about this year's Full Circle Awards.
Watching the circle assemblies for the past 3 years, they have gotten so much better. I love how they incorporate like little skits in this year's a flash mob. I loved how they incorporated that, and it just makes it a lot more interesting for the students.
If the showcase of our peers and teachers wasn't enough, the show capped off with a flash mob in the Thunder Center. I asked Brooke Melillo and Mrs. LaCroix what setting up the flash mob was like and how they thought it went.
At first it was a lot of meetings and discussing our ideas and how we wanted this to go on. And then it went into with a lot of looking through social media for ideas and dances and songs. And then we just kind of put it together from there.
It was a lot of fun. I do miss our rehearsals every day after school, dancing on the stage. And I miss dancing with all the different teachers and staff and students that ended up participating in it. So it was a lot of fun.
Hey MBHS, great Spirit Assembly, and I want to thank and congratulate all of our award winners and recipients. Every day they come to school and they contribute here and they were recognized today. It's not just about their efforts on a day like today, it's every day throughout the school year. Thank you to all the students who nominated their peers. I want to congratulate and thank Mr. Guads and Mrs. Ferrati who put this program together this year, and they did a phenomenal job.
This year was one of the craziest Full Circle Awards we have ever had, and I can't wait to see what happens next.
Well, that's all the time I've got. I have to get back to listening to Spotify with my AirPods. For Jerry Camp, I'm T-Bird News.
Oh, man.
What's wrong, Jerry?
Oh, nothing. I'm just still full from my Thanksgiving meal.
Oh, I feel you big time on that.
Speaking of Thanksgiving, Gianni carved his way through the halls.
Well, one of the greatest traditions we have is the Thanksgiving Day football game. And the biggest, most important tradition of all is the kicking off of the football.
The leaves are changing and the food is cooking. I went to see how Thanksgiving went for MBHS.
From NFL football to the Thanksgiving Day parade, there were many ways to celebrate this year's Thanksgiving.
On Thanksgiving, slept late, went to the horse barn and took care of the horse, and took a good shower and then got ready, and my husband and I went out to meet our family. We all go out for Thanksgiving dinner these days, and so we went out to dinner.
This Thanksgiving, I spent a day or so beforehand getting ready for Thanksgiving, doing the stuffing, the mashed potatoes. I had to open the can of corn and get that ready for the microwave. Very important job, but it was a lot of fun as well.
I got to see what people liked eating on Thanksgiving this year.
And my favorite food is cranberry sauce.
Favorite food on Thanksgiving is turkey.
My favorite food is mashed potatoes and gravy.
Mrs. B's homemade stuffing, secret recipe.
I think I like all food, but I did hit the sweet potato dish 3 times because it was really super good. Lots of chopped nuts and a little honey and really good carbs to help, get you ready for Christmas time.
Well, that wraps up Thanksgiving for this year. For T-Bird News, I'm Gianni Ferriolo.
She wouldn't try to trick me on a traditional holiday. This time I'm gonna kick that football clear to the moon!
For the days leading up to our homecoming game, NBHS students participated in the Spirit Week. Here's Sophia Cavalier with more information on that.
To get everybody excited for the homecoming game, NBHS held their annual Spirit Week. Let's see how everybody represented the new themes this year.
The week started off with the classic USA Day where students wore red, white, and blue. Tuesday allowed students to dress up one more time after Halloween by embracing their inner alien. Wednesday, each grade went against each other wearing their designated colors. Seniors were white, juniors were gray, sophomores were blue, and freshmen were red. On Thursday, friends got together to twin with one another. Finally, on Friday, everyone showed their NB pride by wearing their sports apparel and representing our school colors, purple, black, and white. It looks like everybody really enjoyed Spirit Week and were able to show their school pride. For T-Bird News, I'm Sophia Cavalier.
Now that we saw Spirit Week, let's take it over to the homecoming game. Joe, Chris, and Ant were all on the scene. Let's go see what they have to say.
North Branford High School's homecoming is something that never disappoints. This year, there was a lot to be excited about. Let's go see what went down. This year's homecoming featured many highlights on the sidelines, such as gift baskets, homemade food, customized bottles, and much more that kept the students busy during halftime.
All right, the student section's real loud and pumped up. We got some nice colorful banners, a lot of good food.
VHS students were also able to represent the many clubs that the school offers on the track with their well-designed banners. This has been a tradition for many years now, and it continues to impress. This year's homecoming resulted in much fun for the fans and family that showed up. For T-Bird News, I'm Ant Pugliese.
Big dubs today, boys.
I'm in it to win it, I'ma be the best, yes sir. Started from the bottom, I ain't had no one, yes sir. Had to get big on the Bruce Banner.
The MVP right here. We got the horse himself in the back.
From first downs to touchdowns, the Bird's Nest showed their support for our football team during the homecoming game. They helped cheer the football team to victory over Windsor Locks, Suffield, East Grand.
I'm in the hills, yeah. Counting bills, yeah. I'll get diamonds, chandelier, give a cheer.
Not only was the student section present, there were also tons of families showing their support for their student athletes.
So as you can see, the homecoming game atmosphere was amazing. Thank you guys for all coming out and supporting the team. For T-Bird News, I'm Joe Carbone. Let's go hand it over to Chris for the game.
The homecoming game is here, and I was lucky enough to see the T-Birds take over Windsor Locks.
At the end of the half, the score was 20-12 Thunderbirds. They also had Tyler Napoli being the star player with 3 touchdowns and 198 all-purpose yards.
Attaboy, Trev! Let's go, Trev!
All legends fall in the making. Sorry, truth. Dying young. Demon youth. What's the 27 club? We ain't making it past 21. I've been going through paranoia. So I always gotta keep a gun. Damn, that's the world we live in now. Yeah.
The team had played well and fought hard, but at the end they were on top, ending the game 33-26.
Good win for the Birds, but they were unlucky against Cogginchog, ending the season 7-3. Good luck to the team next year. This is Chris Knight reporting for T-Bird News.
Speaking of sports, the winter sports season has arrived and North Branford is considered a class act school. The CIEC sent out a video this year detailing sportsmanship and the expectations for all fans.
School pride.
Bonding with my squad.
Overcoming challenges.
In high school sports, we learn a lot from what happens on the field.
We shouldn't have to worry about what's going on in the stands.
When fans or parents throw shade at coaches, athletes,
and officials.
It's embarrassing.
For real.
For real.
High school sports can be amazing,
giving us lifelong memories.
So we're asking all fans, please.
Please.
Please. Let us enjoy it.
That's it for this week's news. Next up, our famous holiday show and lip sync video.
Be on the lookout for Mr. Delizio and his camera.
This year's song is What Christmas Means to Me by the legendary artist Stevie Wonder.
I'm Joe Carbone.
And I'm Jerry. We've got you signed, sealed, and delivered.
We're yours.
Lots of snow and ice everywhere.